Hello friends, welcome to Let's Fab. I am Imran, coming with a new tutorial in our pressure vessel fabrication video series. Our today's topic is drawing overviews for flow diagrams, equipment fabrication drawings and piping drawings. In these topics or in this video lecture, we will cover all the diagrams, drawings which are useful in fabrications. So pressure vessel, heat exchanger or any other fact, if you are working in the fabrication field, you must have the knowledge of these three types of basic drawings. That's why we have taken this topic, to just you get an overview and idea about what are the drawings which are useful in fabrications. Although we will make a separate video for study the fabrication drawings, but in this video tutorial, we are just given overviews for all the drawings which are used in the fabrications. First of all, I want to introduce our fabrication apps. Whatever apps, some of the apps names we have shown in the screen, these tools are made by Let's Fab to work in the fabrication field. These are the Android apps which are available in our website www.letsfab.in. In our app section, you will get links of all these apps. You can download these apps from our website or Google Play Store. These are the Android apps which are very helpful while working in a fabrication. If you are working in a fabrication, these tools might be reduce your tedious calculations work, save your times and layouting. These are the faster tools to work in a fabrications. This will definitely reduce your time and it will definitely help you in working in a fabrication field. I have also given a link for this app in top of the cards. You can go from there and download it. We have also given a link in the descriptions so that you can download this app from our website or Google Play Store. If you are not comfortable with the English language, you can also refer our Hindi series for pressure vessel fabrications, and the same videos is also available in Hindi language. You can go there and learn the fabrications. We also provide on a cards link for this Hindi video. Okay, let's move to our today's topics. Press subscribe button to subscribe our channel and press bell icon to get latest notification. Today's topic is the drawing overviews. In the drawing overviews, we are given three types of drawings overview. First of all, flow diagrams, equipment fabrication drawings and piping drawings. We are giving these three drawings overview in this video tutorial. First, we see flow diagrams. In flow diagrams, there are four types of flow diagrams. One is a block flow diagram, process flow diagram, piping and instrumentation diagram, and utility flow diagrams. Out of these four flow diagrams, piping and instrumentation diagrams is the most useful drawings which are used in fabrications and project management or pressure vessels. Whatever you are working in a project, if you are in a project engineer or design engineer, or process engineer, P&ID is the most useful drawings in fabrications. We will brief this P&ID diagrams in later part of this video, and other three types we will just give a overview of that flow diagrams. First we see block flow diagrams. It's called as UFD. It consists of blocks with the input and output lines connected to them. It doesn't show what's involved in the block, but concentrate on input and output flow. Generally, liquid lines are connected to the bottom of the blocks and gaseous lines are connected to the top of the blocks. We have also given a reference BFT drawings for reference to you. In this, whatever in the block, that's not matter, but in this block flow diagram, what are the inputs and what are the outputs, that matters more. Liquid lines are connected to the bottom
of the block and gaseous liner connected at the top of the block. Block diagram basically more concentrated on the input and output. These design conditions are not given in a block diagram. It's given on another diagram. It basically focuses on input lines and output lines. What are the input connected to the particular block and what's output is going to the particular block. This majorly PFD is important for knowing the input and output lines. Next flow diagram is process flow diagram, PFD. It shows the major equipments, major pipings, major instrument, flow directions and design conditions. Basically, process flow diagram consists of this all the equipment, major piping, main instrument, flow direction and design conditions. This all constitutes the process flow diagram. It describes the process flow of the particular project or particular chemical process. In the process flow diagram is similar to the block flow diagram, but the design conditions and flow directions are included in the process flow diagrams. In this major components, equipment are furnace, soaker, all these are the major equipment shown in a process flow diagram. Major pipings are shown in this process flow diagram, major instruments are shown in the process diagrams. Flow directions are given in a process diagram. These are the flow directions coming from this side and going to the this side. Design conditions are just like this, the input is coming 12 bar pressure to the pump and output is going 37.5 bar. These are the design conditions, 6 bar. That means the pressure or temperature is given in the required for the particular process is shown in the process flow diagram. This all constitute a process flow diagram. In process flow diagram, we just get a knowledge of all the what the major equipment, major piping, main instrument, flow directions and design condition. This is the basics of process flow diagram. Next, we go to our next diagram, P&ID diagram. This is called as piping and instrumentation diagram. P&ID diagram generally shows all equipments, all pipings, all piping components such as valves, flanges, instrument, special instrument. That means whatever process is required, whatever equipment, whatever pipings, what are the small elements, whatever is going to use in the particular plant, then it shows in a P&ID diagram. Everything has been available in a P&ID diagram. If you know the P&ID diagram, if you learn P&ID diagram, if you can study the P&ID diagram, you will get a basic idea of the process plant. What actually involved in that process plant, what are the equipments are used in that process, what the piping is going there, which components are using over there. This we will get all details of the process plant in a P&ID diagram. That's why this P&ID diagram is the most useful drawing in a fabrication of project. Basically, this is not used for fabrication, but these are all drawings are connected to the fabrications of equipments. That's why if we have knowledge of all these diagrams, we can usually move forward with the fabrications. If you arise some problems over in a fabrication, you can refer these drawings for your study purpose and you can easily sort out your problem. If you are an engineer, you must have the knowledge of all the drawings so that you can improve your skill and you can have a better value than other engineers. If you are learning fabrication from Let's Fab, our aim is to learn all the things that should make the fabrication engineer should be a perfect. That's why we are taking the overview of these drawings which are connected to the fabrication. In this P&ID diagram, we have given one reference drawing for understanding purpose. In this P&ID diagram, we have taken a small process. That's why it's a small drawing. Actually, if you have a bigger process, it has most of the components, more number of components, pumps and other instruments that are coming to the more numbers. We have just taken a for simplification, we have taken a small process. In this P&ID diagram, we have shown a tank, a pump, and some valves. A solvent is coming from unit 1 to nozzle 1, and other process is happening over there. The nozzle numbers are given to these tanks. Whatever the lines or indicators are connected to that lines that are shown over there, these valves are shown over there, this pump is shown over there. These are the components, all the components are required in this process is shown in over there. Tank numbers are shown inside the tank or top of that sheet. That means this tag P01, P01 that is shown at the top of the sheet. Some specification is shown over there, top of that sheet. This constitutes a P&ID diagram. Basically, P&ID diagram has all the equipment, piping, and other instruments are shown in a P&ID diagram. Next, we see some guidelines which are we must have know about that. We have seen the P&ID guidelines. First guideline is actual location is not shown in the drawing, but horizontal or vertical equipment can be identified. This means in P&ID diagram, we cannot get actual location of the equipment, but we can identify that equipment is a horizontal or vertical. Its nozzle number may or may not be shown on the P&ID diagram. That means whatever nozzle numbers are given here, there N1, N2, it may be shown in the P&ID diagram, it may not be shown. It's not compulsory that nozzle number should be shown on P&ID diagram. Sometimes it's shown or sometimes it's not shown. In our P&ID diagram, we have shown the nozzle number, that's N1, N2, N3, N4, N5, these are. Equipment tag number either shown inside or top of the drawing sheet. What I had told earlier, equipment tag number, that means just T001, P001, that's shown in either inside the drawings or top of the drawings. This top of the drawings, they have made one column for T001, P001, and some design conditions are given over there. Series of the tag number should be same on P&ID diagram. That means whatever series we are using for equipments in P&ID diagram, it should be same. That means if we are using a tank with a T001 series, then next tank should be T002 series. That means series should not be different. That means if you are taking a series for one tank in T001 and another in T1001, that's not a good practice. In a P&ID diagram, series should be same. If you are using tank, if you are given a series of 100, then next component is also the 100 series. In this, we are taking a 001 series. That means we are taking a tank 1 as a T001. If we another tank is involved in our P&ID diagram, we call it as a T002, and next is T002, such like that. We go with the same series so that it can be identified easily. Size of the equipment and instrument not required on the drawings. That means in P&ID diagram, equipment size and instrument are not shown on the P&ID diagram. It's shown in another separate drawings or its specification sheet. Shown another, but in P&ID diagram, sizes of the equipment or instrument are not shown on the P&ID diagram. Flow direction should be from left to right side of the drawing sheet. That means in P&ID diagram, flow directions will be shown from left to right. That means this is the drawing sheet and this is the left side and this is the right side. That means flow is coming from left side and going to right side. So it's coming from left side and going to right side. The flow direction should be left to right. Never try to match nozzle size and line size to decide the nozzle number. That means we could not match the line size or nozzle size to decide nozzle number. That means if we take one this example, if this line is coming of 100 NB, it may not be considered that N1 should be a 100 NB nozzle. It may be different or it may be same. That means line size cannot decide the nozzle number or nozzle size. Hold means that something is shown on the drawing which may or may not be right. It means if hold is shown in the drawing, that means that area should be correct or not correct. If we say, for example, this pump is a hold, if there is written there is a hold, that means whatever inside the cloud it should be correct but should not be correct. That means it's right or it may or may not be right. It not confirm that it is right. That means these hold points are given over there so that whatever working over there, that particular section, we must have to refer what is a hold point. First we have to clear that hold point and then we can move further. In P&ID diagram, line length cannot be known from the P&ID diagram. From P&ID diagram, we could not get the pipeline length. That means water pipeline is connected in the P&ID diagram. The length of that particular P&ID diagram, that means if we consider this line, this is coming from here, and from this wall is going connected to here. That means the length of this line, we cannot measure, or it's not given in a P&ID diagram, what length of this line. How much this line length should be there, it is not shown in a P&ID diagram. We have to go for some other drawings to get the length of that particular line. Reducer may or may not be shown in the drawing sheet. It means whatever in P&ID diagram, reducer may be shown or may not be shown in the drawing. Main lines are shown by dark or thick lines and branch line as a thin line. In P&ID diagram, so whatever the main lines are connected to the equipments or instrument, that should be shown by thick or dark line, or branch line should be a thin line. The lines which are crossing to the other line should be shown by broken. That means if some line is coming over there and it crossing some other line, it should be break over the line. That means it should be showing by breaking this line or by broken line. That means here not shown any example of that, but just consider that this data line is shown over there. If this line is crossing over there, they are showed break here line and then move forward. This is all about P&ID diagram. P&ID diagram is the most important drawing as point of project perspective or at the point of fabrication engineer. We also have, if you have a knowledge of P&ID diagram, it will be always help you in fabrications, working in fabrications. Next flow diagram is utility flow diagram, UFD. UFD, it is a P&ID diagram for plant utilities. It's just similar to the P&ID diagram, but it's made for only a plant utilities. What are the plant utilities? Water lines, air lines, steam lines, condensate line, flare line, drain line. These are the utility lines. That means that does not involve any process on that line. These just are used for the plant utilities, just for cleaning water or supplying compressed air or steam for some other purpose. These are the utility lines. If utility lines are shown in a P&ID diagram, then it is not necessary to make the utility flow diagram. If it's not shown on a P&ID diagram, it must to have make a separate utility flow diagram to show the lines of the utilities. Whatever lines are coming for utility, that should be made by another drawing, utility flow diagram. If it's already mentioned in a P&ID diagram, then it is not necessary to make the UFD or utility flow diagram. Next section we see the equipment fabrication drawings. Whatever the earlier drawings we have shown, these are the flow diagram. That's are the mostly used. If you aware about that drawings, then you can easily understand other drawings, or you have the knowledge of the drawings, then it will be help you in particularly working in a fabrication. Sometimes we have to refer that drawing, but most of the time if you are in a fabrication engineer or you are working in a fabrication, your most point of contact is a fabrication drawing. But if you have knowledge of other drawings also, it will be help to you. Now we see the equipment fabrication drawing. In equipment fabrication drawing, there are 5 types of drawings: equipment layout or plant layout, equipment GA drawing, fabrication equipment fabrication drawing, fabrication layout drawing and equipment assembly drawing. So we will see one by one. First we see the equipment layout or plant layout. This is called as a plant layout or equipment layout. Equipment layout shows actual location of the equipment in the plant area with respect to the control point or origin. That means what is the location of the our equipment in a plant is shown in a equipment plant layout. If we consider origin as at this as a 0 0, that means the location from this point is shown in a plant layout. In this example, they have taken reference as some other level. That's why they have started from 67 north. North or plant north is very important in equipment plant layout. It should be shown on the plant layout. If north direction is not given, then this is not a equipment layout. North direction of the plant should be shown in the equipment layout. It is necessary to show the plant direction. Next necessary component in equipment layout is to give decide some control points or origin. One of the reference point is should be shown. All the respective dimensions should be taken from the one single reference so that we can understand or we can take a reference to all the dimensions. And plant layout or equipment layout is always a plan view. Whatever equipment layout shown in equipment layout drawing, it is a plant view. This is a plan view. The plan, that means the top view. Top view is shown, that means it is a plant layout. And this dimension of this particular equipment is shown from such particular point. This A, B, C, these are the beams or columns of that particular plant layout, and the dimensions are shown over there. That means if we have to know location of this equipment, then we have to see it is an east 196 mm or on north side it is 86.2 mm. From this we get location of that particular. If we want to see the location of this equipment, then we have to see from the north it is 78 and from east it is 109 for the first saddle. And other saddle is also shown here, 196. Our center lines are shown, center distance from these two vessels are shown here. This is a plant layout or equipment layout. Sometimes in equipment layout or plant layout, the floor level is also shown over there. If your plant has a multiple floor, then floor levels is shown by such like that. In the first floor, there is these tanks, and next floor, another. From bottom floor, this is a one floor. That means this elevations are shown in the floor. This is a fourth floor. That means this 11th for third floor. This is a floor level plant layout. Actually, is shown in a plant layout. It is also shown in a plant layout equipment layout. But basically, equipment layout is for a top view. For better understanding, elevations views are also shown in plant layout to understand the height of that particular. In where location in the plan view we will just get north and south dimensions, and for elevation or height of that equipment we get the elevation view. Let me just we consider this is a FMH005 equipment. It is maintained at a center elevation of 13600 from the reference point. From the elevation we will get the elevation view. For height of that particular equipment, we get the floor level or elevation view. In elevation view, we will get from plan view and elevation view, we will get the dimensions or location of that particular equipment. Whatever equipment layout is, equipment layout is most useful and is for only getting the control points or location points of the equipment. There is a use of this equipment layout is only for knowing the actual location of the equipment in our plant, where is actually this equipment is going to install and what is the location of that particular equipment is shown in the equipment layout. Next drawing we see a equipment gear drawing. An equipment gear drawing, it generally shows the general arrangement of equipment. It consists of plan view, elevation view, major dimension, technical details and scope of the equipment. In equipment gear drawings, These all are shown. This is the plan view. We are taken a reference drawings for understanding this. This is plan view. Actually, in this drawing, there is a plan. There is no need of plan view. That's why it's not shown. But is a sectional side view is shown from this side. This view is shown over there. But elevation view is shown here. Major dimensions. That means overall length, overall height. Some major dimensions are shown in GA drawings. Then some technical details. Technical details. This is a section of technical details where the all the technical details are shown. Which core is used for fabrication of these? What are the temperatures? What are the pressures parameters? What are the materials? These technical details are shown over here. A scope of the equipment. Scope of equipment is also shown in the equipment GA drawing so that we can get what actually in our scope and what actually is in other scope. What was shown in the GA drawing, it is in our scope. If something is not in our scope, it clearly mentioned by making a clouding that it's a client scope or any other scope. This is the overview of equipment GA drawings. This is how equipment GA drawing is. Next we see the fabrication drawings. Fabrication drawing shows all details required for equipment fabrication. Then what details are required for equipment fabrication is shown in a fabrication drawing, such as the equipment plan view, elevation view, sectional view, side view, or dimensions, part detailing, welding details, bill of material, design data, nozzle schedule. That's are shown in a fabrication drawing. And this drawing is a major focus of our fabrications. As we are learning a fabrication of pressure vessel, that means the drawing is very useful, and this is the most useful drawing we are using in our coming lectures video series. This drawing is the most referable drawing, and if you are a fabrication engineer, you are the might more contact with the drawings. You might be known about that drawings, but I just give the, in this video we are just giving an overview of the drawings. In the later video, we are making a separate video to study the fabrication drawing so that you will get the details, idea and overview of that fabrication drawing. We are just giving overview in this video. That's why you do not comfortable with it. It's no problem. We will explain all the terms and things in the next video of the fabrication drawing study videos. Okay, you just take overview of from this video. The drawing overview, we will discuss next detailing in next video. Just for reference purpose, we have taken one of drawings. I just explain you the overview. In fabrication drawings, there is elevation view over there. There is a plan view is given over here, and detailings are made on that. These are the welding details. These are the part details. That means it's nozzle manhole details. This manhole detail is shown over here. Some comments are, design comments are shown in a fabrication drawings. Nozzle schedules are shown in a fabrication drawings. Bill of material is shown in a fabrication drawing. Design parameters or design technical details are shown in the fabrication drawing. The complete fabrication drawing is with everything has been explained. Whatever is we are fabricating, whatever dimensions or whatever requirements, whatever dimensions or whatever we think required for fabricating a particular equipment, it should be mentioned on that fabrication drawing. If out of fabrication drawing, you cannot make anything. If you have correct fabrication drawing, you can make the equipment easily, you can fabricate it easily. All the detailings are given in a fabrication drawings. All the details, by referring to fabrication drawings, we can fabricate any equipment or pressure vessel or any vessel. In next video, we will cover it in detail. We are just given an overview of fabrication drawing. Next is a fabrication layout drawing. Fabrication layout drawing consists of flat pattern layout of all the components in a fabrication drawing, such as shell, cone, design. Best practice, it is a best practice to make layout drawing so that we can plan material and save the cost. Layout drawing is very most useful drawing. If your company is not making a layout drawing, then it is not a good practice. If you are making a layout drawing for particular equipment, then it gives a rough idea about what are the materials we are going to use, how it can be cut. It will be save the maximum time of fabrication engineer also, so that he doesn't want to lay out actual layout on the plates, and then after cutting he has to shift. If he has to shift anything, then it gets complicated after marking. If you make a fabrication layout drawing, and then fabrication engineer can easily, or fabricator can easily refer the drawings, and it will be marked the raw material as per layout, so that it can be, material can be saved and cost of the equipment is also saved. For the reference point of view, we have shown one layout drawing for a C-section. One of C-section is shown over there, and the layout for this is shown in this side. What size of the plate is required for fabricating or bending this shown in over there. This cutting dimensions, raw size are over shown over there. If we mark the plate as per this layout and cut it and bend it, we will get this rough sizes is shown in here. If we mark the layout as per the drawings and after cutting that bend, we will get this C-section. But that's all about fabrication layout drawing. We also see layout drawings in our next video, or while we are making a detailing of that, we will show how to lay out a particular thing. If, for example, if we consider this is, for example, this is a vessel, then you have to make the layout for the dish end, this shell and this dish end. That means if you have to lay out that particular equipment, then you have to decide what sheet size you are going to use, and then decide where shell plate is there, where dish end plate is placed. That means you will get just a rough idea or about where this material is cutting from the particular available raw material side. If you plan according to this, then your fabrication cost will be definitely saved, your material cost will be saved, and it definitely minimize the marking times of that fabricator. That's why it is a very good practice to make the fabrication layout drawings. Next drawing we will see equipment assembly drawing. Equipment assembly drawing shows assembly of all the subcomponent or sub equipment of that main equipment with the main equipment. That means whatever the sub equipment or sub components are in that drawing that are shown to make the complete assembly drawing. This is a complete assembly drawing shown in our drawings, and this manhole cover, these boards, these legs, these are the sub components that are made fabricate independently, and then it to assemble with the main major component to work in. Some walls are also over there. That means whatever the sub components are, how it can be met with the main equipment to make complete equipment, that's what about assembly drawing. In assembly drawing, the wall or detailing or all the assembly parts are shown, the location of that assembly parts are shown, and the matching parts are shown, so that we can easily assemble the all the subcomponents to make particular the main equipment. This what about the assembly drawings. Assembly drawing is just for the assembly purpose. If you are not fabricating a pressure vessel, if you are fabricating an agitator or reactor, it has more component, subcomponent, that means the blade, shaft, motor, that are the other components, subcomponents are over there. That's why in that particular is really require assembly drawings to make the assembly of all the equipment. In pressure vessel, if we have not make assembly drawing, it not a matter. You can also use the fabrication drawing to assemble the pressure vessel part. But if you are using agitator or any other equipment, that's how the more subcomponents are going to attach with the main equipment, then it's really necessary to make the equipment assembly drawing. Next we see piping drawings. In piping gear drawing, piping isometrics, full fabrication drawing, and instrument diagram. These four are the major diagrams which are used in a fabrication. If you are working in a fabrication field, you also must have the knowledge of piping drawings. because we are using in a fabrication, most of the piping components we are using in a fabrication, and sometimes we also fabricate the pipelines or piping spools for a vessel connection purpose. That's why we also have knowledge about piping drawings. If you are a piping engineer, you already know about that, but if we are learning a fabrication detail course, then it's our responsibility to know the learn you all the drawings, and you we have to give a description for the all drawings so that you can cannot find any difficulty while working in a fabrication. That's why we have taken this drawings over you for fabrications engineer. Next we see piping drawings. First piping drawing is piping gear drawing. In a piping gear drawings, it shows the piping arrangement, connected equipment, other facilities it wants in the plant, such as pipe drives, equipment, platform, ladder, gauges, supports in a top view with their exact location. In piping gear drawing, exact location of piping is shown over there, whatever the pipe racks are you going to use there, whatever equipment is in there, how it connected to the piping. This is shown in a piping gear drawing. For the reference paper, we are taken a small part of the piping gear drawing. Actually, actual piping gear drawing for the particular plant is much bigger, but we are, for understanding purpose, we have taken over a small section drawings, piping gear drawings. Some notes are given here, and this is the arrangements are shown with the dimensions. All the dimensions are given in a piping gear drawings, major dimensions. Actually, piping gear drawing is not similar to the equipment gear drawing, because in equipment gear drawing there are the only overall dimensions are given over there, but in piping drawings all the dimensions of the pipings are given here, and the locations and where it going to connect it, what components it connect to, shown in the piping gear drawings. And just like a fabrication drawing, this is a piping drawing where we get to all detail regarding the piping drawings. Next piping drawing is a piping isometric drawing. Piping isometric drawing is an isometric drawing, nothing but a detailed orthographic drawing that represents the detail of 3D structure of piping system in 2D format. That means the 3D structure of piping is shown in a 2D format. That means this lines is shown in is an orthographic projection. That means just like a 3D structure, so that we can get an easy idea and how a line is going to over there and which components are connected to that line. This can be shown in a piping isometric drawing. Piping isometric drawing is made for every line. Actually, if your plant having the number of lines, then the isometric drawing should be made for every line, so that the engineer or fabricator can get the detailing of that particular line equipments with that, and he can understand easily and fabricate that line easily. Piping isometric drawing consists of line numbers, flow directions, support and tag locations, piping components and weld locations. This is one typical piping isometric drawing we have shown over there. In piping isometric drawing, north is a very important component, then it should be shown in the piping isometric drawing. What are the components are connected to that isometric is shown in their MTO bill of material is shown over there, and the 3D views is shown here. Actually, piping isometric drawing, if your north is on this side, then you have to make the quadrant for that. There are up, down, north, east, west, south, or a down, none, this is up. That means if you are reading this drawing, that means this first is this line going to the up, then it goes to the east, then it goes to the down, then it again goes to the east, then it goes to the south, and it goes to the up. This type, and this way this drawing can be read to understand. And from these drawings we get all the walls which are going to connect, all fittings we are connected to that lines, whatever components are connected to make that line is shown in a piping isometric drawing. To better understanding piping isometric drawing is necessary while fabrication. If you know the piping isometric drawings, you can easily fabricate the pipelines, or you can easily work on a fabrication of pipelines or piping equipment. Next piping drawing is spool fabrication drawings. Spool is nothing but a small part of pipeline that is fabricated in a workshop and later then it used in a site. The prefabricated component of piping systems are called as a pipe spool. They include pipes, flanges, fittings, and they are mounted during the fabrication before they are delivered to the construction. That means spool is fabricated in workshop. The small line it makes in a workshop, it can be made with a welding, or all the assembly can be made in a workshop, and this complete assembly used in a construction and assembled to the site directly. Spool is just a small part of lines. That means if you are fabricating a spool, that means you are fabricating a small part of particular pipeline. That means this, we have shown one spool drawing over there. This is a spool drawing for one line. This is a small line. In this small line, there is a flange, pipe, elbow, this pipe, a T section is over there, this wall is over there. This is a bypass section actually made from this to this. This main line is made the bypass section, and all the piping components, flanges, walls, pipes, elbows, these that are shown over this spool fabrication drawing. You have to fabricate that spool as per the drawings, and it directly sent to the site to connect the main line, whatever it main line will be there. It directly connected with the flanges, or it can be directly welded to the site. There is the direct. If you have to weld on the site, there the flag is shown over there for a field weld. In spool fabrication, the MTO is also given so that we can identify the component in the spool drawings. This is what about spool fabrication drawings. Next drawing is instrument hookup drawings. In instrument hookup drawings is a detailed drawing showing the typical installation of instrument in correct manner so that instrument operates properly. To operate the instrument properly, we have to know how the instrument is going to connect with a particular line or our equipment. What are the other components are going to connect with that particular lines is shown in the instrument hookup drawing. Basically show the arrangement of that instrument with the main lines or main equipment. For example, we have taken the pressure gauge instrument hookup drawing. In this pressure gauge instrument hookup drawing, we have to connect this pressure gauge. This is a main line. Actually, in this hookup drawing, we have to show that one pipe connection is, flange connection is taken from the main line, then the one wall is connected over here, there, then reducer is connected over there, and then this pressure gauge is installed. That means for installing this pressure gauge, there are some number of piping components are involved with that particular pressure gauge. That means there is also given a name for that one, that is the blind plane, nipple, tube cap. These all are required to take this pressure gauge from the main line. This is how we can arrange this particular instrument with the main instrument so that this instrument should be worked properly. That's what about the instrument hookup drawing. In instrument hookup drawing, we have to get detailed idea about how the instrument is going to assemble, or how to that particular instrument is going to installed with our main equipment or main line. That's what about the instrument hookup drawing. If you have to install some instrument with your line or equipment, you have to refer the instrument hookup drawing. If you are fabricating that parts, then you have to also must have knowledge about the instrument hookup drawing. So that instrument hookup drawing is also used in a fabrication drawings. If you are a fabrication, you must also have the knowledge of instrument hookup drawing. If you have the knowledge of all the drawings, then you can become a very good fabrication engineer. Or whatever drawings we are covered in this video, there are flow diagrams, equipment fabrication drawings, or piping drawings. That is a really very helpful you while in a fabrication. If you have the knowledge of these drawings, you can definitely become a good engineer or a good fabricator. If you have particular skill, they can use it in your daily activity. Majorly, fabrication drawing is most important for fabrication engineer, but these all other drawings are just supporting you to become a good engineer or good fabricator. That's why we have covered these drawings. We have given overview of that all the drawings so that you can have some detailing or some overview of the drawings. Whenever we talk in our videos or next tutorial the drawings, so that you cannot be unaware of that. That's why we have taken this drawings series over you, so that whenever we take the name of the drawings, you can easily connect your mind with the drawings and you have the knowledge of that. Basic knowledge is most important. Actually, in your fabrications, we really need a fabrication drawings. We will cover a separate video on study the fabrication drawings to understand the particular fabrication. In this video, we are just given an overview of that. Overview for that. Drawings. And the last part I want to introduce you that we have made lots of Android apps for fabrication community to minimize their work to make the faster. You can download our app by visiting our website in our app section and you can use it freely. If you have any idea which is, or if you require some tools which are really frequently used in fabrication but it's not available anywhere, you can share your idea with commenting below this video. If you like your ideas, we will make it to happen and we will make with that tools and it will be available for everyone. You can follow us on Facebook page, you can follow us on Instagram, you can follow us on Twitter. If you like our video, please subscribe our video, comment and share with your friends so that they can get complete knowledge of the fabrication. Thank you.